morning to see what the fashions will be next season. The whole community gathers here.
And London is completely wacky.
Do you go to all of the fashion weeks?
Just London.
This is where all the trends are set. This is where all the business deals are done. All the big buyers will come here with their budgets and decide how to spend them.
The Japanese and Chinese markets.
The fashion students will come here to learn.
I studied at Colchester School of Art Design in the sticks.
It's a circus. The whole thing is a big travelling circus. It's just very, very exciting. It's very inspiring.
Very frou-frou, very frilly. Mm-hmm. With the patent.
It's very important to the fashion industry. It's very important to the economy of the capital. A lot of money is spent here. It's not just frivolity, but it is fun.
I always say to people that London fashion is different to the other three capitals of the world. Now, that's sometimes a strength, sometimes a bit of a weakness, but the one thing you can be certain about in London is you're always going to get newness, excitement, fun, and that slight cutting edge, which always means that's the next trend coming through.
And we've got people with daring.
Yes.
And, you know, enthusiasm and passion. And they're not afraid to take risks on the catwalk.
I've already got a couple of orders this morning. Today? On the first day, yes.
And what about London Fashion Week as a whole? How important is that to you?
This is a really good platform for me to showcase my stuff to both UK and international buyers and press.
The British Fashion Council New Generation offered me a place here.
So this is Topshop sponsored?
Yeah.
Up and coming, interesting designer.
Yeah.
So if you were to explain your point of view on shoes in a sentence?
What would I say? The higher the better for the moment.
And it's suspiciously like the one that Naomi Campbell fell off. Practically kitten heel.
So Caroline Charles is a stalwart on the London fashion scene. She showed her first collection in 1964 and, in her own words, focuses on grown-up and groomed glamour. Having said that, there are some clear trends here that we'll see interpreted across the market for Autumn 08. This collection has a very 1940s feel, which is a key influence this season, and this colour palette is one we're seeing across many collections. Patent accessories, again, are a key look here. This show's finishing here with two very beautiful evening gowns in two more key shades of bright blue and teal, again with plenty of embellishment, which we're seeing everywhere this season. All in all, it's as she promised, grown up, groomed and glamorous. That you did last year win the British Fashion Export Award, yes. Which was fantastic. Did you both take responsibility for that? Or?
Yeah, no, that's all
that's I yours. That's you. That's all your fault. It works though, isn't it? I shouldn't say that, should I? Seasons have you been showing at London Fashion Week?
13 years.
13 years, so you're a veteran of London.
I think I'm one of the oldest ones. Well, you get the press coming round, mm-hmm. And also I get my orders, so yeah. It's my bread and butter for the next 6 months.
Really?
Yeah, the inspiration's all very natural, looking at flowers, mm-hmm. And also looking at vintage laces. All the cashmere's from Scottish mills.
Right, so this is a sourced in Britain, made in Britain.
Yeah.
Skiwear! I've just come back from skiing.
I think it's more après ski than actually music when they go skiing. Yeah. And so we did this wrap here, which was £10,000.
£10,000? Where do you get your inspiration from?
And what? Isn't it? Shines, I quite like it.
Yeah. And where do you manufacture?
All in the UK.
All in the UK?
Yeah.
Is that important to you, to be made over
here? I think so. I mean, it's sort of getting harder and harder, like all of these are woven up in Scotland.
They went big
red wolf is not that scary.
And there's an eye mark.
No cape. No, well, there was one in the photo shoot, really. But we couldn't foresee selling many of them.
No.
They never know.
Well,
would you like one?
I think I'll pass. This is very beautiful.
The whip is optional, yeah? This is going to be a part of the Orient Express story, which is about Paris and Istanbul. The tassel, so it's reminiscent of a Turkish hat. The locket is reminiscent of the secret messages they exchange on the train.
Oh no! Did she kill herself? Or did she shoot her lover?
She kills herself because he goes back to France.
Yeah.
I'm such a swot.
So you've really researched this, haven't you?
I am a swot.
With your catwalk show.
I am exceptionally delighted with the show. I mean,
really strong.
I had only seen a percentage of that product.
Oh really? So yes. It was quite fresh to you?
I saw it very much in the early stages, drawing board, fabric, and then to see it on the runway. Sadly, it all goes too quickly.
Yeah. For Jaeger London now, isn't it?
It's 125 years almost of Jaeger.
Yeah.
First runway show ever.
You'll get great press from it, and I'll just take it onto another level.
Get back to nature. I ain't talking about no walk in the park. I ain't talking about no kiss in the dark. I ain't talking about breaking the hearts. I be talking about taking you apart. Won't be talking about this and that. Cause you'll be crawling with the jungle cat. Finally, finally caught you, don't you think?